Hello again everyone. I'm on my own today and I'm back in Cambridgeshire. I haven't been here for a while. I'm in the village of Papworth Everard and I'm doing a little walk from Country Walking magazine. It's an old one. It's 9.5 miles, should take about 4.5 hours. And yeah, it's a Wednesday today. I've got 5 days off work, booked holiday, paid as well. So I'm making the most of it, getting out, walking. At the moment, it's unclear on whether I'm going to be wild camping or not tonight. Hopefully I can. I've packed enough stuff in my Osprey Talon 33 rucksack in order to do so. Got me OEX Fox 1 one-man tent. And I've also got something new as well. All the food I'm carrying is from a British Army ration pack, 24-hour pack. It's menu number 14, written it on my hand so I don't forget. I've got into them lately, and I've been buying them on eBay and stuff, and yeah, sort of getting some good deals and stuff. Andy, my mate, Kent Survival, he inspired me to sort of give him a try and stuff after watching a few of his like MRE and ration pack reviews. So yeah, I'm gonna see what it's like. I've got tons of food in there and stuff. Took it out of the cardboard box that it comes in and managed to squeeze it in my rucksack, so I'm going to be cooking up some of that later and doing breakfast and stuff. As I say, that's if I wild camp, but I think I'm going to give it a go anyway. The weather's sort of cloudy. Apparently this week, the week that I'm off work as well, on holiday, it's forecast as like heavy rain and thunderstorms and lightning. Typical, as always, so... But today is okay, so we're going to give it a go anyway. See, I've got the OS map with me as well. And yeah, we're outside St Peter's Church here. Sort of on the outskirts of Papworth Everard. I've parked the car sort of further away in the village and sort of walked down to this spot. So anyways, enough talking. Let's get walking. You know the score. Let's go through that door. Okay, welcome back. I don't know if you can hear me, but I'm in Yelling. It's actually called Yelling, the place. Yeah, got a little bit lost earlier on. And this country walking route is rubbish, by the way. Their navigational skills are probably worse than mine. Throwing me off the completely wrong way. They told me to take a footpath that doesn't exist. So I've kind of created my own route, but involves adding a little bit more time onto it and mileage anyway. So yeah, Yelling, what a name. So I've stopped for something to eat here at the church at Yelling, and yeah, I've got this British Army MOD ration pack. It's a 24-hour one. As I said before, it's menu 14, and yeah, so there's a ton of food in here, and I'm just going to try out a couple of the snacks and stuff now because I need to stop and eat something quickly. I'm absolutely shattered from getting lost and then having to navigate me way again. So I'm just going to go with the cold stuff that they've got in here. They even give you a light stick as well, which I thought was quite nice. There's some of these little sweets. Don't know what flavour they are, so I'll probably try one of those first. I've got nut and raisin mix, so we'll have some of that, and a little fruit explosion, like mixed fruit puree thing. So we've got that, and we've got some dark chocolate chip oat biscuits or cookies by the sound of things. There's cheddar cheese crackers, and there is as well some cheese spread. Always need your cheese, and I mean, you know, because it might have separated. Yeah, I mean, there's tons of teas, coffees in it, everything, and there's an FRH or flameless ration heater, and a sleeve and a beverage bag thing as well. So I'll probably do all that, as I say, if I camp tonight. Hopefully I will. I've also been drinking this apple flavoured like isotonic drink while I've been walking. It's really nice. And that, I'm so sad I even kept the sachet that had come in. There we go. So it's by Beyond the Beaten Track, fruit flavoured energy drink powder, apple flavour. Pretty tasty actually, it's not bad. And a lot of people say they're quite weak, like the taste is quite weak. I mean, I've put that in a 500ml bottle and it tastes great, so yeah, I don't know, it's worked anyway. Anyways, right, crack on with the first bit of food. So let's try out the raisin and nut mix. It's not bad. Like a mixture of like peanuts, I think dry roasted nuts, walnuts. Oh, there's some cashews in there. It's not bad. Give you some energy, which I need. Yeah. There we go. I don't know if you can see that. Hmm. Yeah, I rate it. I'm not going to do not a full-on review like Andy does. He's the expert in that. I'll leave him to do that, so. But they are pretty cool, these ration packs, I'm not going to lie. Next thing, we'll try the fruit explosion. Oh, that's all right, that. I like that. Oh. It's quite runny. It's literally like baby food, but yeah, I rate that. It's all right. So, yellow cap. It tells you what flavour it is. So this is apple, mango and banana, apparently. Yeah, I'd buy that. You don't get a lot in it. I've nearly finished it already. That's nice. Reminds me of my uncle. No, he's a decent bloke. Nothing like that. Yeah, that's pretty decent, that. Oh. Very runny. Right. Then we'll move on to the biscuits or cookies. So they're a little bit broken up inside, but try a little bit. They're alright. They taste a bit like malted milk biscuits, I would say. With a hint of chocolate in them. I'll be honest with you, I can't remember the last time I had a biscuit. I'm trying to cut them out of my diet and stuff. I usually find I'm eating more crap elsewhere though, but so these are pretty good actually, yeah. Very nice indeed. I probably should have had them with the teas and the coffees, but I can't be asked to sit and cook up a hot drink right now. It's warm out as well. I don't find hot drinks refreshing like some people do. But yeah, they're very good. And then the next thing is these little sweets. Like I say, I don't know what flavour they are, but there's about four or five of them. I don't think they're chewy. If they have got a flavour, it's not very strong, but I think they're orange flavour. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. But yeah, not bad. I mean, you definitely can't chew them, you break your teeth. Yeah, so the next thing I'll probably have will be the cheddar cheese crackers and the cheese spread. We'll give that a go, see what that's like. Okay, time for the cheddar cheese crackers. They're probably really broken up. Oh, okay. Right, so they're not really crackers. They're like, if you can see this, they're like, it's a little desiccant packet, the little air absorber. They're like little rolls of, I don't know,
cracker with like cheese in. So I don't know where you put the cheese spread that comes with this menu. We'll see anyway. Let's give these a try. They're quite nice actually. They remind me of tuck biscuits with the cheese in the middle. Slight salty flavour to them. Not a very strong cheese taste, but just enough. It's quite nice. Not what I was expecting, but still, they're not bad at all. We've reached the tiny little village of Papworth St Agnes. Lovely thatched cottages all along the little lanes. And I don't know what this building here is. It's got bars on it. It looks pretty old. It's got a big tall chimney stack on it. It's old wooden door on it, whether it was an old lock up. Look how nice this house is here. Ah, it's got a post box built into the side of it. Yeah, I don't know what that could be. Anyway, I think we're heading that way towards the church. We're about to cross Ermine Street, or Ermine Street, however you want to pronounce it, which is an old Roman road. We've arrived in the little village of Hilton, and this is the parish church, St Mary Magdalene Church. And we've got quite a big village green here, by the looks of things. The pub isn't actually on the route. It's just off Mill Hall, I think it says, near there. That's sort of another road going into Hilton. In fact, there's a cat there. In fact, this route doesn't have any pubs on it, which is a bit of a disappointment, I'm not going to lie. Okay, so the next thing to try out of the 24-hour military ration pack is Beyond the Beaten Track cola flavour drink powder with sugar and sweeteners. I've got a tropical flavour one, but I'm going to save that, I think. I'm going to see what this one's like. So, got some water. I'm going to fill it up a little bit more once I've got the powder in, mix it up, and let's see what it's like. Okay, so it being cola flavour, it's a slightly darker colour version of piss than the last drink I had, the apple flavoured one. That was like light piss colour, you know, when you've drunk plenty of water throughout the day and your piss is a bit lighter. This is like if you've been drinking like shitloads of booze and you're dehydrated, coloured piss. In fact, I think if your piss was that dark, you'd probably be in hospital.
So, funnily enough, actually, Papworth Everard has a world famous hospital. The whole place is like to do with hospitals and stuff, and yeah, saw lots of nurses about. Yeah, that's all I'm going to say on that. Anyway, right, let's give this a go. Smells quite nice. It's not bad, it's definitely got a taste to it. I mean, you know, it doesn't taste like Coca-Cola or Pepsi, of course, but it's definitely got that cola bottle flavour, like the sweets. Yeah, it's not bad at all. Not too bad, it'll keep me going anyway. It's very like muggy and humid out today. Like, I'm just sweating, but like it's cloudy, there's no sun. It's just really, really warm, horrible. Anyways, yeah, there we go.
The village hall at Hilton was opened as a church school in 1856. It still retains its school bell on the roof, and one can still see on the bricks of the porch the carved initials of former pupils. 100 years later, the school was closed, and school children were bused into Fenstanton and St Ives. Hilton Maze is one of only 8 surviving turf mazes in England. According to the Latin inscription on the monument in the centre, it was cut in 1660 by the 19-year-old William Sparrow to commemorate the restoration of Charles II to the throne. He probably copied the pattern of the maze from a maze now destroyed at Comberton, where his brother-in-law, Baron Brittain, lived. The maze, like all turf mazes, is unicursal. That is to say, it has one single path with no wrong turnings, coiled into an endless labyrinth. This particular pattern is often found in medieval art, most notably on the floor of Chartres Cathedral in France. The origin of mazes is uncertain, but it has been suggested that they were used as a sort of mini pilgrimage to be traversed on one's knees as a penance, alternatively that they were used in a rite to cast out the devil, who could move only in straight lines. Turf mazes were once common on village greens, but they disappear as if they are neglected, as Shakespeare suggests in A Midsummer Night's Dream, and the quaint mazes in the wanton green, for lack of tread, are indistinguishable. Lancelot Capability Brown, the great 18th century landscape designer who rose from humble beginnings to be the royal gardener, was lord of the manor of Fenstanton and Hilton from 1768 until his death in 1783, and high sheriff for Huntingdonshire in 1770. He had a map of Hilton made by his foreman, John Spires, in 1778. There is no record that he laid out Hilton Green, but before some of the older trees came down, it was certainly worthy of him. In 1983, the second centenary of his death, a tree was planted near the maze to commemorate the man who had planted a million others.
I've just seen a sign, a footpath sign, saying Papworth Everard 2. And I'm following that route now. It's just outside the village of Ellsworth. And pretty much everything here is all farmland. It's one of the few things I dislike about Cambridgeshire. A lot of the walks I've done in Cambridgeshire have always been full of farmland and stuff, and
There's nowhere really to camp, so you guessed it, I'm not going to wild camp tonight. I've got about an hour of daylight left. It's just gone 8 o'clock, so it's still baking hot, like just muggy as fuck. It's horrible. And yeah, I reckon I can finish this walk by 9 o'clock. I've got the head torches and stuff with me in the rucksack, so it's not a problem. Yeah, no wild camp tonight, I'm afraid. I wasn't too sure at the beginning of this walk, like I said, because I know that it's full of stuff like this and it don't look like it's going to get any better. So it's still been nice to get out and do a walk, of course, but I'm not going to lie, it's been a little bit boring. Not because I've been on me Todd, but just not a lot to see really. The villages were nice, but all of this is just farmland. I mean, well, I think I've just seen a pillbox over there. Anyway, right, I think I'm heading that way. So yeah, let's get this walk done. Right, I'm almost back at Papworth Everard, and we're going to have our last drink from the military ration pack of the day. So this is tropical flavour drink powder with sugar and sweeteners. Chuck it in the bottle, mix it up, give it a go. Okay, it's got it all mixed up, sort of somewhere between the cola dark piss colour of the last one and the apple one. So this is looks more orangey, so it's tropical flavour. Let's give it a go. It smells lovely. Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, that's all right, that. Excellent. This will keep me going for the last mile and a bit that I've got. I haven't got far. I can see houses through the trees and stuff. There's loads of people out tonight though. I've just seen a family of three walking their dog, a cyclist, he looked like he was going bikepacking actually, he had a cool little rucksack on, and I don't know, it looked like he could have had like wild camping gear in there as well. I saw two younger blokes, quite posh blokes, with shotguns. That put me off wild camping for definite. They gave me directions this way to Papworth Everard, so nice people, just don't like guns. I can see another couple of people heading towards me along this track, so nice evening for it, isn't it, really? You know, get out and walk and stuff. Should always do it, definitely. Yeah, shame no wild camp, but not the end of the world. So there's some woodland here, like Papworth Wood and stuff like that, but who knows who owns it? I mean, could be the geezers with the shotguns, so you know what I mean. You don't want to wake up and have like both barrels staring down at you, do you? So yeah, so I'm just going to drink my tropical drink, get on back to the car, I think. Ah, lovely stuff. I can see my car just behind this one here. I've done it. Yes! Proper happy. Well, that weren't too bad. I'm really pleased with that. I wasn't too sure. As I say, about navigating that, I got lost a couple of times on that walk. The directions and stuff on this were not great, I'm not gonna lie, but yeah, my car is literally right in front of me here. That's not too bad to come out right there, and I'm parked right there as well. So yeah, I think I'm gonna love you and leave you. Hope you've enjoyed this little walk, and here we are, here's the car. Anyways, cheers for watching. Get in the comments, let us know what you think, if you've been round this way before. See me again soon. See you later. Cheers. Bye.